the boy's fee, is actually a criminal. And the BPO that came was actually right to have also said that, look, this guy is a criminal. We are only saying that since we have a department that can specially take care of that child, we first deployed that department, the men in that department, to do their work before handing over to the DPO to also continue with the prosecution if we are not interested, or if we think that we feel it's more of a criminal thing that the police should handle, or if we feel that, well, why shouldn't even they have, maybe they have even discovered that the man has some other things that we have really not investigated. So it is not a matter of saying one is doing right or one is doing wrong. It's a matter of we are just doing our own aspect of the joint mandate that we have. Yes, the Babalawos, well, we keep on investigating. When we see any of them that has criminal traces, we look into it and get them arrested and get them prosecuted as well. How prepared are we for Boko Haram? I'm not going to also tell you that on this platform, telling you what we have been able to do, because I also know that people Boko Haram are also listening to this radio, so that I don't tell them what I want to do and they will now say, okay, this is what they want to do, and they also keep on improving on what they want to also do. But I can assure you that we are on ground, and we are working together to make sure that the state is secure. Now, the issue of siren, I just gave an example now. I have my siren and they are working perfectly. But I didn't use it when I was coming. I had to just make sure that the lane are just two. One is coming, one is going. Instead of having four, five lanes at the side, and they were just squeezing the motorists at the other side to just, you know, even pushing them out of the road. That's what we do. I've been telling people when they say that our officers are men, there are some people that use our stickers. I said, when you see them having issues of security, something that will not even take us a long time, is giving us a lot of headaches because people are not really giving information. In this part of the world, I always say it when I have an opportunity like this, that it is only in this part of the world that we greet people till tomorrow. Odaro. Or Shegobe or Kachifu, they all mean Odaro. It is because we know that in this part of the world, that morning will surely come. And Oyinboma will not greet you Odaro. They will only wish you a good night because they know so many things can happen between the night and the morning. If I'm leaving this studio now, I can also tell the anchor here that I'm coming. Mumbo. It's also a reflection that nothing, I'm so sure that I will come back. And Oyinboma will just tell you, excuse me, because he knows that he may not come back. And that's why you see even a probably 40, 50-year-old millionaire hiring a 70-year-old guard to be guarding him. Then who should be guarding who? It is because we are so unconscious of security. And that's why we are not giving information. Like, as I assure you, if you give us proper information, we will attend to it and it will be treated in confidence. We are quite aware of the need for us to have a post traumatic treatment for our officers when they experience trauma. That one is, we do it. In fact, we have a department, that is the forensic department, that even examine officer every now and then after a major operation. We counsel them and we also tell them that look, what you have seen here and there, it can happen to even them, apart from the one that happened to other members of the public that they witnessed, that they are, that's making them to become a traumatic. We are attending to that, and we also know that it's very, very important to also get that treatment so that they will also not be affected. Yes, not all of us are carrying gun that you see. You only carry gun where you need gun. It's not as if, because we are still monitoring, we are still providing security for human beings. We are not hunting. It is only, we deploy our weapons when it is very, very necessary. For those who are not carrying weapons, how they are protected, I don't think I also want to say that here, so that they will also not know how they are protected. But I can assure you that they are protected in a way. Of course, collective efficacy, community support and all that, I think civil defense is enjoying a lot of that. Otherwise, we wouldn't be able to do so many things. For instance, those operations that we have been carrying out on pipelines, on communities and all that, they this were based on intelligence and as well as information from few members of the community. What we are saying is that we still need more. I'm going to repeat this one. There is no static perfection. So we are having community support. If there is any support we are having at all, particularly since I came to the state, I think it's the support from the community. I can assure you that we will keep on doing what we also make that support to continue. Thank you.